our 23 million viewers on YouTube, our 13 million viewers on Kumu, sa Facebook, hindi ko alam kung ilan, but I know that there are a lot of you who have been waiting for this Financial Saturday again. If this is your first time, you are on the Salvices YouTube channel live. Ako po si Salvi Duplito, ang financial beshi ng bayan na tinatawag. At napaka-welcome po sa inyong lahat. Magandang umaga, magandang tanghali, magandang gabi sa lahat ng mga nanonood here and around the world. Ngayong araw na ito, handa kayo dahil bigatin ang ating mga guests na in-invite for tonight. Matututo tayo magnegosyo, matututo tayo mag-invest, at we will take all your live questions later on in the show. Kaya ipapapasok ko na ang aking partner na si Warren De Guzman. Hi, Warren!
Okay, hello to our viewers. Good evening from the Philippines. Hello to everybody who's already saying hi on the stream. Melody, Israel, Aries, all our regulars are here. Hi, guys! Thanks for coming on again.
And totoo yan,
ang ganda ng lineup natin tonight.
Nakalimutan mo siya. Na.
Oh, excited ako. Nakalimutan mo yung tax tips na...
yes! Magpapakita
na
yun.
Ano,
ha?
Kanina, nagbayad lang ako ng amilyar.
Kailangan yan. Dahil malapit ang April 15, kaya from now until April 15, marami po tayong ibibigay na videos, informational videos para sa mga bagets, para sa mga perang YOLO at sa mga entrepreneurs. Maraming tips kung paano masisiguro na hindi tayo magbabayad ng extra, 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 pati ng mga fees and charges dahil nakaligtaan lang natin ang amilyar. Kaya, excited talaga ako para partner Warren for tonight. Parang siguro sana hindi tayo umabot ng oras. Pero feeling ko laging bitin kasi tayo, no?
Lagi. Always on a Saturday. So I guess we should go into it na, no? Para diretso na tayo sa mga guests natin na really accomplished guests later on. So are we gonna go into the video first?
Yes. So ipapakita po natin, this is a short teaser, yung video na ipapalabas natin tomorrow. Who should watch this? Mga freelancers, mga professionals, talents, mga entrepreneurs, lawyers, doctors, at mga bata na nagsisimula pa lang sa kanilang career at hindi pa alam mo pag taxes kasi parang nagsha-shutdown agad ang utak natin. But these videos that we are going to release, make it a bit sexy, make it a bit easier to understand. Lagi tayo may pa-sexy, di ba?
It's important kasi yung administration na to, ginugulo nila, binabago nila ang taxes. Ang daming tax reform na nangyayari. Diba? Sinabi ko gulo eh, no? Pero ang dami lang yung ginagawa, like cutting some of the tax rates and that latest one, the CREATE bill, it should lapse into law soon within this month. So you have to be prepared for that, especially if you are an entrepreneur. So we're so glad that we got Mr. Mon Abrea to come on for a video tomorrow.
Yes, let's talk tax, baby. At oh, wait lang. Kung bago po kayo, first time ninyo manood ngayon, don't forget subscribe to the YouTube channel and all our social media pages. Follow Warren De Guzman on Twitter para lagi kayo
on Twitter.
On business news. At palabas na natin ang ating teaser video for today.
The employed, you are considered
self-employed.
Whether you're a businessman, iba pa yung tax na binabayaran ng business mo, di ba? Iba yun sa personal income tax mo. So kung ikaw negosyante, dentist, doctor, lawyer, talent, ano pa?
Influencers, artista, live streamers, graphic artist, kahit ano, basta meron kang...
Freelancers, yes, yung mga freelancers. Ano ngayon, kumikita sa mga online clients nila.
Pero, Bes, para naman hindi matakot yung mga viewers natin, meron naman din threshold na wala pang income tax or exempted pa.
Okay, ano yung threshold na yun?
250,000. So, pag 250,000 pa lang...
Siguro naman talagang hindi ka na dapat kinukuhaan ng tax nun, di ba?
No, 150,000 best, ano yun, net taxable income, ibig sabihin, yun lang yung kinita mo talaga. Pag hindi na magpasa 250,000, parehas na mga employees. So yung employees, kapag hindi lumagpas sa 250,000 yung annual salary nila, or yung nagbi-business na self-employed, pag hindi lumagpas sa 250,000 yung kinita niya, income tax exempted.
How do you prove that?
Declaration. Remember, it's voluntary assessment. It's the job of the BIR to investigate, to check if it seems kung parang hindi match, parang hindi totoo. Pero everything else is voluntary.
Okay. Pag lumagpas ka doon, kailangan nang mag-file.
Yes.
No, kahit na piso lang.
Kahit hindi lumagpas, magpa-file ka pa rin.
Remember, magpa-file ka pa rin.
Filing is totally different from paying. So, guys, huwag kayo matakot sa pag-file kasi hindi necessarily may babayaran.
Yes.
Even yung annual filing, takot na takot, ay, mag-April 15 na, chill. Baka wala ka nang babayaran. Diba?
Ayan!
Alright!
Promise po talaga, bukas, we'll make tax simple, easy to understand. Tapos meron kayong ching in your mind kung ano talaga ang gagawin nyo.
Or, hire nyo na lang someone.
Pwede rin naman, download ang TaxSwiss app. Makikita nyo dun si Chibi, he gives lahat po ng mga questions siya mismo sumasagot dun. So, Partner Warren, that's going to be tomorrow, uploaded at 8 p.m. every Sunday, ang ating bagong videos on our services YouTube channel. Sa ngayon naman, excited ako na ipakilala ang ating susunod na guest. Siya po ay kilalang kilala, lalo na ng mga batang 80s, di ba? At siya ay, wait lang, one moment. Siya ay Agora Awardee for Entrepreneurship, Agora Awardee for Entrepreneurship, at meron siyang 3-time National Books Awards finalist and produced 6 best-selling non-fiction books with Anvil Publishing, at marami pa po siyang other accomplishments. Just today, he was voted as best, sabihin ko na naman female, best male host sa podcast sa Asia. Ipaakyat na nga natin para siya na lang magkwento ng kanyang mga new awards. In the house, baby.
Ay, maraming salamat. Yung ating financial beshi, Salve. At of course, yung ating rakista, business reporter, Warren De Guzman. Maraming salamat sa invitation nyo na maging kasama dito sa Salve Says. It's really quite a pleasure. Actually, mas interesado makinig sa sasabihin ng next guest ninyo dahil alam ko kung saan natin ilalagay yung pera natin, di ba? Yung ating imaginary money, alam na natin kung saan natin ilalagay ngayon. At sana makakatulong ako sa lahat ng mga nakikinig ngayon, lahat ng mga 23 million followers ni Salve. Sana may mapulot sila sa aking sasabihin ngayong gabi.
Tenor Austin, thank you for joining the stream. Marami na po tayo mga viewers on Kumu. I know you're also on Kumu, RJ.
Yes.
Mag-hello lang ako. At meron na rin tayong virtual gift, si Josephine. Nag-send ang halo-halo. Maraming salamat.
Ay, maraming salamat sa halo-halo.
Thank you po. At maraming po tayo mga
dami.
14 million na. Maraming salamat po.
Ay, Salve, nanonood pala yung mami ko, si Consul Fortune Ledesma, nanonood mula sa FB Live. Gusto ko lang batiin lang.
Hello!
Baka magalit sa akin, hindi ko siya binabate. Pag-online kami.
Importante niyan. Ayan. On Facebook, people are also waiting for all your nuggets of wisdom. And on YouTube, marami na rin nag-aabang because this is becoming a habit nga daw. Na every Saturday, inaabangan talaga nila. Ayan, see?
Saturday.
No? We always see them come in. Thank you, Paul. Renz, maraming salamat. Ayan, meron from London. Iba-ibang
parte. Wow, social.
Hello.
Hello. Kumusta si Megan at si Princess, si Queen Elizabeth?
Wow.
Assalamualaikum, Marlon. Pasensya po ako. Hosting ako sa paminsan-minsan. Naging hosting pag mentality ko. Pag ako'y nasa naging guest, naging host pa rin ako. Pag ako yung nagiging isang speaker eh.
Mahirap yung tanggalin, ano? And so,
mahirap.
Ang dami mo namang ginagawa. Ano ba yan, RJ? May bounce back ka? 1 year na?
One year anniversary. Congratulations, Bounce Back Philippines. Ito sa Founder Jason De La Rosa.
Thank you for that. Mercato is back.
Yes,
also,
that's right.
Awards. And ano ba yung mga bago mong awards? Kasi ang dami mong awards eh. Nakikita ko lagi sa Facebook. Oh.
Ayan, mamaya, kwento na lang. Kwentuhan muna tayo tungkol sa kung paano magkakatulong sa ating mga sabi. Okay lang sa akin yan kasi yung mga awards, mababasa nila online. But for this one, there's so much I want to give back. Dahil sa panahon ngayon, especially with Bounce Back at sa Mercato, gusto ko sana ibalik sa ating mga kasama ngayon kung ano magagawa nila ngayon, especially pagdating sa pagkain. Because, hindi ba napansin, ay, gusto ko yan, nakikita ko si Salve, pati si Warren dyan sa site para makapag-interact tayo, di ba? Ang ganda mo, Salve. Ang gwapo mo, Warren. Tama ba ako? Dito pala. Warren, ang gwapo mo. Ang ganda mo. Ayan, ganyan pala yan, ganyan pala yan. Okay.
RJ, bago ka pumunta dyan sa pagkakanegosyoan, meron lang akong itatanong sa'yo. Kung okay lang. Sino ba talaga si Jenny sa buhay mo?
Ay, yung Jenny ko nandyan. Sweetheart, saan ka? Nako, hindi. Nagma-makeup ko yan eh. Baka mamay papagalitan pa ako niyan eh. Pag pumunta dito at hindi na kaayos.
Ito yung Jenny na alam ko eh. Palabas mo nga, Ralph, yung picture.
Ayan. Pakita mo nga, pakita mo, Ralph.
Ralph, please.
Production team. Backstage. Ilabas mo na. Sayang naman yung cue.
Okay.
Sayang yung segway natin.
Anyway.
Ayan, hinanap. Ayan. Oh. Alam niyo po, pag nakikita niyo dyan yan, yung this is the interesting thing, sabi mo nga kanina, nakikilala nga ako ng mga batang 80s. So kung kayo po ay hindi lumaki sa 80s, hindi niyo ako kilala. So si Warren, hindi na ako kilala. Pero ako rin po yung
nagturo ng... Hindi, kilala kita. Ikaw talaga.
Eh, pero ito ha, if you might, people might remember me from the 80s for Royal True Orange. Pero in the early 2000s, I had a show, Studio 23, called The Men's Room, kasama ni Tim Tayag. At si Juan, I'm sure, gising yan para manood niyan eh. Late night na yan eh. It was a very critically acclaimed show. You know, it was critical because my mom was very critical of the show eh.
Ayan.
Pareho pa rin yung itsura. Tinan mo naman yan. Okay.
Pinipirin ko talaga na, no? Para malaman
ayan, look at that body. Look at that body. Oh. Body by Royal True Orange yan. Kita mo yan, Salve. Yan.
Meron eh. Ayan, no?
Ayan. Guwapo naman.
Ayan. Minabas na lahat ni Raz. Kasi ano.
Nabibigyan ko yung mga tao. Ayan. Oh. Wow.
Yan. Iconic picture.
Let me tell you a story. That commercial, that set of those series of Royal True Orange commercials came out from 1988 to 1991. And the director for the first set of the commercials was actually Lino Broca, the late great Lino Broca, who if you know, wow, directed Maynila sa Kukunang Liwanag.
So Esther, it was Richie Salas, yes, from Cool Best Fam. They're all here.
Oh, thanks so much for listening.
Yeah.
So very interesting. This came out back in the 80s. We did about 15. Actually, we did 15 commercials all together. And what's nice to find out is that in these commercials, they were actually, I mean, I'm quite surprised, taken, you know, it still blows my mind, yung mga naging director, Lino Broca, Ishmael Bernal, Peke Galiaga, and Lori Reyes, and si Mongolian Barbecue, Mr. Shuli, Jun Urbano, were all the directors of those commercials back in the 80s. So it was a nice time to grow up, it was a nice time to, you know, experience growing up in the 80s and
alam mo, having a public life. Bago na uso yung mga commercials na may istorya, ikaw na pala unang nagpauso nun.
Oh, yan, so, yung nauna kami.
Uso mo rin yung mga kabataan na gustong kumita additional and natututo mag-bake, natututo magluto.
Tama, okay. Ito yung gusto ko ikwento sa kanila, di ba? So, let's go back a bit more into the height of the pandemic a couple of months ago. Hindi ba natin napansin na ang dami-dami nagbebenta ng pagkain online because we were all stuck at home, right? And people didn't have any other sources of income. Either they were very bored, may cabin fever, or they needed to create some income. So they started selling everything online. But if you notice that, you know, with the deluge of everything being sold online, you know, all of a sudden, it peaked maybe up to the burn month, but after that, it really dropped because people started saying, this might not be something that I can do longer term, or it's not sustainable, or maybe their food wasn't standing out, or they weren't in the correct platforms. They weren't anywhere online where people could find them. So what I really want to point out to people, and this is what I teach bilang isang entrepreneur, is that you have to have that sort of entrepreneurial mindset when you approach becoming a small food entrepreneur. And what is this entrepreneurial mindset? An entrepreneurial mindset basically is that you are somebody who looks for opportunities. I often call it like you're wearing an entrepreneurial lens. Eh? And when you wear an entrepreneurial lens, it doesn't matter if the situation is good or bad. It's just that there's always opportunity. So if you look at people like Dennis Uy or Injap Sia, or even my own partner, si Jomag on the potato corner. They don't say pre-pandemic, there's opportunity. During pandemic, there's opportunity. Post-pandemic, there's still opportunity. The thing over here is, how do you turn that opportunity? How do you turn that opportunity into a business opportunity? Or what I say, how do you turn your irritations into an inspiration for doing this?
Gusto ko yun. How to
turn
into inspiration? Si Tenor Austin is watching. He is turning the pandemic into something that can give a lot of good vibes to people by singing more. I feel like kumakanta siya ngayong pandemya.
Exactly. So you turn that irritation into an inspiration for doing business. And you know, kasi it's basically this, diba, right? Kung ako ay naiirita sa isang bagay, at kayo rin ay naiirita sa isang bagay, kung ma-address ko, kung masasolve ko yung problem, your irritation, dyan ako kikita ng pera. Diba? That's really how you should think about it. So, how does this link back to what was happening during the height of the crisis? If everybody was producing the same thing during the time, diba? Irritation into inspiration, everybody was producing food. But the question you want to ask yourself is, what problem are you trying to solve? Because many people before, when they approach me to mentor for me, they go, "Sir, ano magandang negosyo itayo? Pwede kaya milk tea? Kasi successful yung milk tea na malapit sa akin, so ako rin magagawa ng milk tea." Uh-huh. If you have that sort of me too mentality, gagayahin mo yung ibang tao kasi nakikita mo successful sila, then your success is marginal, it's short-lived. Ibig sabihin yan, you will only be as successful until somebody else comes up with a cheaper product than you or a better product than you.
So how the do you find the best product?
Sorry?
The best product for you.
And that's it. So this is where I'm going to get to it. Now, what problem are you trying to solve? In other words, it goes back to the basic idea of marketing, diba? You go back, okay, what type of food product do you see it's not being produced out there in the market right now, diba? During the time, nagka-sushi bake lahat ng tao. Naka-ube cheese pa na sa lahat ng mga tao. So people were doing all these different things online right now. But what you want to make sure is that you want to make sure that your food stands out. So I often tell people, okay, the first thing is that there's a problem out there. So people are hungry. You're creating something for them, food, diba? But the thing is, when you create something for them, I often tell people, what can you do that not other people can do? What is it in your skill set that is unique and innovative? Because I often tell people, when you solve a problem, innovation lies in the uniqueness of how you are able to solve that problem. And that's what I call your secret sauce. Secret sauce is what you need in all your products to make sure that it's different. People also call it different terms. I like what my boss, John Mack, calls it's a potato corner. He calls that his unfair advantage. What is your secret sauce or what is your unfair advantage so that you will stand out online? So,
maganda you draw that up. Kasi the businessmen you mentioned kanina, Dennis Uy, they're opening a new telecom. Si Injap Sia, he's listing a new real estate investment trust. These guys are really rich, diba? Yung unfair advantage nila. They really have a lot of capital behind them. Paano naman mag-innovate yung mga walang capital and are still looking for other income streams?
Let's go for smaller things. Okay, for example, let's take a look at, I often tell people, what problem are you trying to solve? Let's say food, no? If you're hungry and you're in a hurry and you're hungry, diba? Gusto mo ng KFC. Kunyari, gusto mo ng KFC because it solves the problem of hunger, right? But what is the secret? Diba? But what's the secret sauce of KFC? You go to KFC because of its, number one, 11 secret herbs and spices. And number two, yung gravy nila. Because it's unique to everybody else. That's their literally secret sauce. Or, for example, when you're thirsty, you go to, let's say, for example, you drink Coca-Cola as a soft drink versus other soft drinks because you like the formulation. So we're saying, what are you going to be doing different when you create a product? Or when you create a product, is there a specific skill set that you have that you can produce it better than anybody else? Do you have access to specific ingredients that nobody else can access? Diba? So for example, kung ikaw ay gagawa ng isa pang ube cheese pandesal, eh lahat na gumagawa ng ube cheese pandesal. But do you have a skill set? Can you produce a 4-cheese ube cheese pandesal na malambot pa rin yung cheese sa loob? Can you do it na may ube halaya sa loob na galing sa Good Shepherd? Pati yung cheese galing, it's Laguna cheese. I mean, there's different things so that you can stand out online. And that's where you start. But you've got to make that product stand out, especially when you're online. And there, I mean, it's a whole different issue when you want to market it. But that's not number one. No? How do you make that unique product that nobody else can copy? Kunyari, si Chef Sao Del Rosario, You know, Chef Sal de Rosario in Pampanga, he got trained in France. He put up his new restaurant right now in Poblacion. And people are going for his Buko Pie. Yung kanyang social na Buko Pie, di ba? But, any, I mean, people in Laguna make Buko Pie a lot. But then, what makes it different? His secret sauce is his skill set that he brings to producing that great Buko Pie that everybody wants to get. So that's what I'm saying to you right now, that if you're going to produce, it doesn't have to be expensive, but the thought process behind bringing it there has to make it different. Kunyari, ikaw po ay galing, you can make heritage food, right? Because not everybody has access to food that is that you and your family have been eating for many years. Your specific province, your, or you make inasal, di ba? And you're really from that area.
Pinangat.
But you've got to bring... What is your skill set over there, diba? What makes it different for you when you produce that food product? Because nobody else can do it because you have that skill set of hundreds of years or your generations worth of producing.
RJ, skill set ko kumain. Yun ang problema ko. Skill set ko kumain.
So, that's what and the other thing I also one more thing that I just wanted to point out, no? Especially when you're online, because it's cluttered online and daming tao online. So what I often tell people is that what you might want to do, and this is sometimes what some restaurants do, is that you produce what you call is your signature dish and what I call your food porn dish. And the difference, your signature dish is that that's the best tasting dish that you have, right? Para everybody goes back to that one. But sometimes kasi hindi ka napapansin online, what you want to do is you want to create something that's bonggang-bongga, di ba? Maybe super cheese, delicious, or chili cheese, ube cheese pandesa, something that people don't really order, but when you post online, wow, ano tong nakaka-intriga, di ba? You visit that specific dish, right? But you start seeing, you don't order that dish, but you see all the other dishes that are under there that are best sellers, di ba?
So marketing din.
It goes back to marketing.
Tanong.
Go ahead.
How do you deal with an increasingly negative outlook because of COVID-19. So we're seeing more cases again, very sad. We're coming up on the first year anniversary of the lockdown. And then today we had 5,000 new cases. So how does that affect your entrepreneurial mindset? Diba? Yeah.
So okay.
How do you attack?
I understand. Again, remember, me, regular person. Oh no, there is an increase in the cases, diba? Oh no, there's more social distancing. Me as an entrepreneur, what are the opportunities that are coming out because of more social distancing? What are the opportunities which are coming out because of more cases coming up? So what does that just tell me to do? Then it just tells me that what are the other avenues right now that I'll be able to better market the product? Can I do something better in terms of the logistic or delivery experience? Can I produce more home-cooked food? Because, diba, one of the things which grew a lot during this time was, diba, food being sent to the house. What can you do to improve that experience? Or the other one for me, what am I doing? One of the things I realized that during this crisis is that it will be the increase of what we call cloud kitchens, diba? What are cloud kitchens? Mm-hmm. Basically, you don't have a full kitchen for people to go to, right? You have a commissary kitchen where people go. Now, take a look at the Mercato Central experience. What did we realize at this time, right? I had to close down my market. Whatever happened, diba, Warren, at the height of kasagsagan ng crisis, I had to close down because I was a place of mass gathering. So I couldn't open my market anymore. So what did I have to do? I learned something from this guy named Bong Fadulyon, president of Phoenix. I had said, RJ, you force yourself to open the business kahit sa kasagsagan ng ECQ. Why? Because you'll fail a lot, but in all the failures, you will iterate until you find the correct business model. So I tried everything. People were doing e-commerce. I was having my own delivery service. And this one nugget of wisdom which I gained is that basically when people were ordering from Mercato online, they wanted the same Mercato experience which they got offline, which was what? To order from several vendors at the same time. But when I was doing that online, the problem there was that when people would order from me, backstage, diba, they were ordering from different vendors. So when that was happening, they were being charged several delivery charges, diba? So pag ikaw ay customer, you get discouraged. You don't want to charge all that. You don't want all that. Yes, but what's the pain point there? What can I solve? If I can give you one delivery charge for all those different vendors in one place, then that's where I will make money. So we created the Mercato United Kitchen. So right now, we're opening up in by May 2021, we're opening up one place where we put together all the top vendors from Mercato, and you can order from them online for one delivery charge.
Napansin so, ko, RJ, napansin ko, mga negosyante dapat matigas ang sikmura. Hindi na pwedeng lalamya-lamya ka, napagod lang, natakot ka, ayaw mo na. Kailangan dalawa.
Umabot na 100,000 peso na iwan sa aming account ng Mercato noong time na yan. And syempre nakakatakot yan bilang isang entrepreneur. But the point is, we had to keep on iterating until we found the correct business model. So eventually, di ba, nung time na yan, we were able to say, okay, we did, you know, since Mercato could not go to your, you could not go to Mercato, we brought Mercato to your house, gumagawa kayo ng Mercato sa isang condo. Di ba? We break small Mercatos there. We tried online delivery. Until eventually, we were able to create a safe, socially distanced, outdoor market that conformed to IATF protocols, di ba? Because yan yung irritation ng mga tao ngayon, di ba? Again, it's going back to irritation comes to inspiration. People don't want to eat indoor kasi natatakot sila, especially sa mall. But they're okay outdoor. At the same time, marami mga restaurants and small food vendors were struggling. Irritation, we created an inspiration, nakabukas kami ulit in a very IATF safety protocol type market outdoor. And wow, outdoor is the way to go right now. So nakabukas na kami sa BGC, dalawa na sa BGC, isa sa SM Mall of Asia, isa sa SM Sky Ranch. Ngayon, we just opened up this weekend. We're also opening up right now in Nuvali. And we've got several other locations being lined up right now because we turned that irritation into an inspiration. Ito pa, we learned, di ba? Ang dami mga maliit na food MSMEs na lumago during this crisis. But the problem is that there is no one place that is aggregating them. Unlike your larger delivery aggregators, they don't cater to the small vendors kasi taga-bahay ka lang, di ba? Yung gumagawa ka ng pagkain sa bahay. So, you know, they can't take the charge maybe of the, and they don't want to take the risk or the charge for these larger aggregators. But that's my business. My business is the small food MSME. So, nakita ko yan, at I partnered up with somebody who won together in the Asia CEO Awards of 2019. We both won awards. So, I won for SME of the Year. He won for Tech Company of the Year. He's now my partner, David Almirol of Multisys. And we're coming up with a Mercato app. The Mercato app aggregates all the small food.
Congrats!
And then you can order from there, we can deliver, at nakakatulong ka at the same time para lumaki yung ating mga MSMEs.
Pero
what? I-hypnotize ko kay RJ. We have to move on. Back,
okay, let's go. Sabi ko, kahit na madadata ako, tatalo na ako. Basta sinabi ni RJ, okay ito, let's go. Now, we're going to bring you back later for the live Q&A, I'm sure. All our viewers, kumusta po kayo mga nasa Kumu? This is your chance. Kumu, Facebook, YouTube. Saan pa ba tayo? Lahat kayo na gustong magtanong kay RJ about how to turn your kusina into money, pera, magtanong na po kayo kasi bihira lang to. Tsaka sa susunod na babalik siya, magcha-charge na siya. Kaya, I take this opportunity na. Sino yung, ayan, wow, Warren Buffett de Guzman ka na ngayon.
Oh, wow. High praise. So, kilala ko yan si Francis Valencia.
Kasi excited na rin si RJ makinig.
Okay, so our next guest, very accomplished. He's the director of AXA Philippines. He's a global asset manager. He's with Wealth Archie. He's going to tell us where we can put our money into for our passive income, semi-passive income. So, you know, instead of entrepreneurship naman, investment naman tayo ngayon. Let's bring him on. Dexter Agkawili. Dexter, hello.
Hello. Good morning, Aaron.
Hello.
Good morning, dahil in AXA, we always say good morning.
Good morning. And,
ang hirap tapatan yung energy ni ano eh. Ni RJ.
RJ.
Peroka. Para medyo.
Peroka ba yan?
Peroka.
Dex, meron dito mga laging nag-aabang every Saturday for hot stock tips. Gusto ko lang mag-hello sa kanila sa Facebook. Si Carlea, si Brian nasa YouTube, si Jenilyn nasa Facebook, Okram J nasa YouTube, J. Tolentino, yun yung Lodi kanina nagka-ano. Tapos si ito nakakatuwa, si Maria Dolores Dulay is on YouTube but is also on Kumu, watching us on two platforms. Maraming salamat.
Shider!
RG Estores, Tom Barba on Facebook, Wen Concepcion, Renz, of course, Emma, Paul, and many others na hindi ko na talaga sila mabasa because we really want to listen to your hot stock tip for the week.
Wow.
Let's go, Dex.
Na-pressure ako dyan, ha? Okay. So, una, let's put it into context. No? Dahil unang-una, more of long-term investor tayo. You know? The proper disclosure lang, kumbaga, itong stock that I'm going to talk about is part of my retirement portfolio, kumbaga. Inaccumulate ko siya. Over time, especially during the pandemic, I took it as an opportunity to actually accumulate this particular stock. Now, ang presentation ko, I entitled it as Investing Long-Term, Betting on Recovery. Now, I know we are still at the midst of a global pandemic. Nasa kalagitnaan pa lang tayo. Kung titignan talaga natin, health emergency, nandun pa rin tayo sa health emergency. Pero unti-unti na nakikita natin ng next stage, which is yung economic challenges. And hindi lang yan here in the Philippines, economic challenges yan globally. And kasama na dyan yung tipong kinakailangan mag-spend ng government para to help stimulate the economy or tulungan rin yung mga nasa mailaylayan, kung tawagin, di ba? Kailangan matulungan din yung mga nahihirapan talaga dahil mataas yung unemployment natin. Now, as we try to recover, merong mga critical parts of the system, the economic system, na makakatulong sa pag-recover natin. So, in your previous episode, I think, napag-usapan nyo about a consumer stock, di ba? Eh, isa sa mga challenges natin with consumption is that paano ka gagastos kung wala kang kita, di ba? Yung connectado siya sa kung wala kang trabaho, wala kang kita, paano ako mag-consume? Tapos lahat tayo ngayon, karamihan nasa bahay, and please stay lang sa bahay dahil medyo nag-i-spike nga, sabi nga ni Warren kanina. No? Now, I'd like to reiterate na pagkatapos ng economic challenges is the recovery, and there is a particular system, what we call the banking system. It's the financial system that is really important, very integral sa economy, to help boost and start that recovery process. Mm-hmm. Now, and that's where banks are really important. And at this stage, na nasa kalagitnaan pa rin tayo ng pandemya, dapat ang hinahanap natin is value. And that's why I'm really passionate about this particular stock, Metro Bank. And again, full disclosure, it's part of my portfolio. I am invested in this stock. And let's go through this on both sides, on technical side, technical analysis kung tawagin, and the fundamental analysis. Kasi sabi, actually my first life in investments is as an investment analyst and also a global equities trader. I also had the chance to get to know those big people in the technical analysis world. So one good thing about Metro Bank after the 2020 pandemic, 2020 during the pandemic, it has already bottomed out. So nakakita niyo just a chart na may parang square for almost 1 year. It's trading within 30 to 40 pesos. It's so cheap at that level. And mga latter part of 2020, it already started to move up. Ito yung turnaround situation kung tawagin natin. In the stock market, aakyat, pag nasa durok na yan, magsa-sideways yan at pwedeng bumaba. And then, kapag pababa naman, same way, pag nagsettle na yan, magta-turn around na yan. Nandun na siya sa above 260-day moving average, as technicians would say. And also above the 100-day moving average, where the momentum to go up is there. And why? Yung babalik tayo sa sinasabi ko kanina about value. Now, when we look at fundamentals and when we look at banks, isang key multiplier na tinitignan natin dyan is price to book. Ano ba itong price to book value? So price to book value of Metro Bank is 0.6 times. Anong ibig sabihin nito? Kung titignan mo yung presyo ngayon at 48, and then kung titignan mo yung kumpanya, kung hahati-hati, bebenta mo yung kumpanya at its book value, anong makukuha mo? Kumbaga, kung binili mo at 60 centavos, makukuha mo piso. Just simplistically putting price to book value. Ibig sabihin, talagang at a very sale price siya. Sale, as in, hindi fair, sale siya. And the third point, which is very important for banks, is how stable it is, how good the asset quality it is, it has, and yung client base niya, which is, ewan ko kung alam nyo, no? Pero Metro Bank actually was formed by entrepreneurs. And it's mainly a corporate bank, corporate banking bank. So, that translates to what? Most of their customers are corporates. Okay, the big corporates. And meron din siyang mga retail customers, of course. Pero ang kinaganda nito is that when it comes to, yes, ma'am, may tanong ka.
Hindi, retail customer. Pero this is very Ben Graham. The price to book value is very Ben Graham value investor talaga siya.
Yes. And again, ito yung tipong pang-retirement mo. Saan mo ba itataya ang retirement mo? And kung tipong nag-iipon ka para sa retirement mo, periodically, maglalagay ka, di ba? It's a
oh, good opportunity. Dex, Philip Castro, what's up, Dex?
Hey, Phil! Okay, all the way from Cebu. All right.
So, pang-retirement Yes.
Dex, may tanong ako. So umakyat na siya and it's moved up from the lows from last year based on your chart. Pero ano yung magandang entry point? Should we still buy at this point? Umakyat na siya eh. Okay pa rin ba yung valuation?
Kasi right now at price to book of 0.6, it's still a good entry point. To give you a perspective, no. The likes of the other big three, the BDO and BPI, ang multiplier niya is 1.2, 1.1 price to book. So, siya nasa 0.6. And based naman sa mga estimates ng mga brokers, average fair value is at 92. So, there's still that upside. And what's happening now, it's consolidating or moving sideways at a range between 52 or to mga 40... Mga nasa 43-45. So at the current level 47-48, it's actually a good time to buy. Pero try to buy it as ito yung technique pagdating sa value investing eh. Always reverse your emotions. If everybody is panicking, tipong gusto magbenta, be brave.
Opposite ka.
Oh, parang
maganda 'yan, maganda 'yan. Reverse your emotions.
Reverse. Kasi si Charlie mag-reverse. Always, balik ta rin, sabi ni Charlie, reverse. Question, Dex, question lang. At this point, kasi we might have a debt crisis. Hindi ba maapektuhan ang Metro Bank on that? Because NPLs are going up. We know that this crisis is very, very long. Apektado rin mga corporates, both big and small. Kung hindi makapagbayad ng loans, paano?
Well, dun maganda ang if the bank has enough capital. Yung capital adequacy ratio kung tinitignan natin. No? So, amongst the banks, next slide please.
Next slide. Hindi po ito yung CAR na umaandar. This is the CAR na may tinanong sa capital ng banko.
CAR or capital adequacy ratio. So, ito yung tinitignan kung how much capital do you have. And one good thing with Metro Bank, it has the highest CAR amongst the big three. And kahilera niya sa CAR is Security Bank. But again, that's a different tier naman of banks. So, but when we talk of the big three, like BPI, BDO, Metro, one good thing with Metro is they do have that. So dito tumatama kapag meron kang losses eh. Diba? Diyan tatama yan eh. Now, that's one aspect that when we talk of how stable, how resilient a bank is, we look at the capital adequacy ratio. Also, another is asset quality. Yung asset quality, kasi isa sa mga business nila, aside from trading, bonds, currencies, is talaga the core business is lending, di ba? Mm-hmm. And matanong ko, gaano nga ba kadaling umutang sa mga big three banks? Medyo pahirapan eh, di ba? Kahit ako, sandabukan lang mga dokumento ang papapirmahan sa iyo at hindi marirelease yan hanggat hindi na secure ang Pero ang point ko is that one good thing with the likes of these big three and Metro Bank is their credit, the credit quality of their loan book. Now, if we're to look at another ratio, which is yung net non-performing loans, ito yung mga nagiging delinquent and all. One good thing is that, yes, nag-inch up, but it's still below the average. It's around 2.5. Can we swipe it to the next slide? And
baka pwede mo na isingit yung mga hugot lines mo dyan, ah.
Ayan. mamaya yung mga hugot lines natin. No? Pero one good thing is when we talk of NPL ratio, is it's below the median. Metro Bank is at 2.25. And yung next column dyan sa lower table is yung NPL cover. NPL cover is that kung meron ka kunyaring 100 million na NPL or non-performing loans, nag-provide ka na ba para doon? Kumbaga, ito another, tinanggal mo na yung 100 million na rin yun sa income mo para ibang gamon na kinoconsider mo, loss na siya. Okay.
Yes.
And one good thing with the, this particular stock, or this particular bank, is that it has the highest NPL cover. Meaning, kumbaga, ito yung handa na siyang mag-move on eh. Handa na mag-move on. NPL cover, hindi lang 100%, 174% handa na siyang mag-move on. Na tipong, sige, let's do business, di ba? And doon naman papasok yung next point ko about it being a corporate bank. Kung titignan natin ang economy, syempre, maraming nagihirap. Tapos, yung mga SMEs, yes, yung mga nalugi sa mga businesses, tapos, syempre, iaaho nila yan, di ba? Eh, pero kung titignan natin, ano ba ang usually unang gumagastos? Ano ba yung usually unang nag-ooperate? It's the big corporates.
Yeah.
Corporates, kapag nakikita nila, okay, unti-unting nag-iisap na, sige, let's now resume operations. Or corporates or certain firms na nag-shift na ng business model. Kailangan na natin bumili ng mga bagong equipment, kailangan na natin bumili ng bagong IT infrastructure because iba na yung ating business model. And that's where banks come in. They start lending, they start mobilizing funds. And that's that's the advantage and the edge of the next bank. Yes.
Regarding sa banking, di ba, there's also a change in the business model. And some of the banks on your list, ano na sila, very heavy na sila on digital banking, like Security Bank and Union Bank. Why not those banks? Kasi yun, very popular sila ngayon. And yung iba pa, ING, they're also actually into those really high interest savings accounts. What do you think of those banks?
Okay. So the mention about the likes of Union Bank, which is one of those who are also ahead when it comes to digital banking. They have a solid book rin naman. And as far as, it's just that more of valuation-wise, nauna na eh. I mean, kung ikukumpara natin, merong mga certain banks na tipong talagang nauna nang umakyat yung kanilang price, stock price. And yung the likes of the others, some like ING, they're not listed naman with the stock exchange.
Okay. Next, we're running out of time. Maybe we can continue this discussion. We bring up RJ Desma because we have some questions from the stream already. So please continue later when we're going to talk about more on investments. It's now 8:45 in my clock. I'll just let you finish your thought before I send the question for RJ in the stream. Sige. Finish your thought. If you were going to finish your thought or you want to go to the first question now.
Oh, okay. We can go to the Q&A now. Okay.
Sorry. Okay. Just doing my job as the timekeeper. Okay. Platino is asking, thank you for this insightful session. Any advice as to how we can be better convincing sellers, marketers of our food products apart from having a secret sauce?
your product itself should be able to sell. I mean, it's if it's marketed well and if you're able to communicate it well, then it's able to move. For example, diba, if you know what literally some products have really great sauce, right? Then you've got to communicate this. My product is this one with super secret special sauce. Yun yung bebenta mo, diba? Or if you go to a, let's say, if you look for a, even if it's takoyaki, what are you the most cheesiest takoyaki? What is that secret sauce you have to identify para mabenta mo yan, eh, diba? Sometimes, you know, it's not that you keep on pushing to the seller. Sometimes the seller wants to go to you, which is like in my case, I make sure that in my market, there are specific vendors who have to join because their products are the secret sauce. No need to push to me. Kasi alam ko magaling sila, bagnet patong. Ang sarap ng bagnet patong nila because there's a way that they do it na that only they can do it very well. And then we have, it's called Thai Mango. They've got this special drink. It was a dessert drink. They made their the mango dessert into a drink, which is really, really good. Everybody looks for them. And I look for them as well. Because RG, oh.
Si Thai Mango, we had them in On The Money when they pitched.
Yes, I remember. James
Reed. They pitched to James Reed. Masarap talaga siya. Masarap talaga siya. Yes. You know, it's that uniqueness also, I think, in the business. It's not just, but actually, it's not just also the product, but it's how you tell the story of the product.
And you have to remember nowadays, I didn't get to say it earlier on, but when you sell a product nowadays, it has to have a story and it's meaningful and relevant. If you're listening to what Dex had to say, basically, he was using numbers to tell the story of why Metro Bank is relevant, right?
Comments ano ako kay Warren eh. Pag si Dex nag-explain, parang ang klaro bigla. Di ba? Parang ang simple, ang galing ng pagkaka-explain.
Madali.
That's how you market your product also.
So for example, I'll tell you. When it comes to food, for example, the story is that, let's say a certain food, like if you were to buy two coffee brands in the market, two coffees were there, right? Two. Now, one is regular coffee beans, Arabica coffee beans, right? The other one is Arabica coffee beans that were made in the Cordillera region. And then every time that you buy a beans from them, you are supporting the building of an indigenous school. De siyempre, di ba? You want to buy the one with a good story that is meaningful and relevant.
Yes, it's as simple as that.
That's marketing for you when it's unique, innovative, secret sauce, and tells a story that is meaningful and relevant to the consumer.
You know, that's also how I choose my investments. Oh, di ba? Kasegue lang ako dun sa Dex Agawili. I also like to buy stocks that have stories. Ayoko nung ano lang, palak lang kasi it's big. Okay, pasok ka na kasi feeling mo aakyat na yung ano, yung price niya. But I like the ones with stories because I find that they're the ones who survive the test of time. Yeah. Di ba?
Hindi parang GameStop, di ba?
Ayan na. But guys, I know you guys are beaten. So please press 1 if you want them back in the show. We have to
industry. Tapos tayo, wag muna.
Tingnan mo, ayaw mo ng partner ko, 8:48 na po. Oo, sobrang
beaten. Sige pa, sayang naman.
Oh. We will invite you again. But Dex, last round of talaga kinaaway ako ng partner ko kasi gusto ko mag-interview.
Dito lang yan si Dexter. Tanong natin si Dexter, yung mga ibang viewers natin, they don't really have a lot of money, ano. Very minimal lang yung pwede ipasok sa investment. So, kung maliit lang yung pwede lang ipasok, saan mo ilalagay?
Okay. Magkano yung maliit? 10,000? 10,000?
5,000?
Ayan, ang dami nag 1-1-1. Gusto kayong
Well, so kung hindi naman, well, hindi naman malaki or maliit, it doesn't matter. Pero, say, unang-una, if more of nagsisimula ka, more of have that discipline to set it aside. And as simple as like unit investment trust funds or mutual funds, you start there. What is important is you build that discipline of setting aside money. Okay? That will work for you in the future. Yeah. Now, kung mahirap rin kasi kung maliit lang tapos mag-stock pick ka, medyo mahirap yung gano'n dahil masyadong magiging, ilan lang yung stocks na makuha mo. So best that you first start with the likes of a UITF, mutual fund, or a variable unit link fund.
Yon. So, quick pointer yan para sa mga nagsisimula pa lang. Also, what I like about that, Dex, is when they do that, instantly diversified yung kanilang pera. So, their risk is lower as opposed to just buying one stock. And it gives them already the feeling of the ups and downs of the market without exposing them to too much risk, no? So, that's a great way to begin your investment journey. Very good question, partner. Si partner, maraming
RJ naman kay RJ. Kay RJ, maliit na yung puhunan ng ano ng mga manunood. Should they go into business?
Especially
if they haven't done before, if they haven't tried it before, if they have like 10,000 pesos, should they start now or
no? I often tell people that it's a different mentality, eh, di ba? So like for my personally, I have some money set aside for investment. I have some money set aside for entrepreneurship. Because to be honest, I don't know if Dex agrees with me or not, but sometimes I make more money in my own entrepreneurial business in terms of returns than I do for my business. Because you give more of yourself and more, you know, parang you can create your own capital when you do business for yourself. That's but true. Again, when you do business for yourself, it doesn't have to be food, di ba? Pwede puhunan mo yung laway mo. Pwede ka maging insurance agent advisor ng AXA, di ba? O yan, Lex, ha? No, if you want to, you can do MLM, you can do online real estate brokering. There are many ways for you to generate money. The important thing is the hustle that you have because in the end, if you want to grow a business or get investment, then it's also an irritation. Then find an inspiration to get it, di ba? Like, look, guys, look, I'm a host, di ba? But I still run a business because sometimes before, I had to get puhunan for my hosting to put into my business, di ba? But in the end, it worked out. So that's how people have to think about it, di ba? You are only limited by your ability to think about where you can generate your cash flow for yourself, di ba? Laway puhunan. MLM puhunan, di ba? Insurance puhunan mo.
Okay, yung pangayong. Diba? Kulang pa yung kwentuhan natin sa franchise. But guys, we really have to say bye-bye. Maraming salamat po. Kumusta po kayo dyan sa Kumu? Andyan pa rin ang ating viewers. Hindi sila umalis. Nandyan pa rin. Maraming salamat po sa lahat ng virtual gifts ninyo. Muntik na po tayo mag-isang oras kaya nagmamadali na po ako. Swab test lang daw ang takway ang pukunan. On YouTube, we have 94 viewers. On Facebook, we have pa-check nga sa Facebook kung ilan ang viewers natin. A lot of hearts. Please share pa rin.
Even 63 viewers on Facebook.
It's gonna be thousands after one
akala day. Ko 24, so 23,900. Yes. 2 million, sorry.
Yes po, meron pong recording ito sa YouTube so you can check the entire video again from beginning. Please don't forget, subscribe to the YouTube channel. We have a new YouTube sensation here! Dex Agawili! Nabiti ng mga tao niyo at saka ni RJ.
Please watch the RJ Ledesma podcast every Tuesday. I have my own podcast channel, RJ Ledesma Podcast. This coming Tuesday, interviewing Cheryl Quintana, founder of Foray Spa and president of the Philippine Franchise Association.
Okay, Jen Fernandez on Kumu, maraming salamat. RJ is so passionate about the things he does. Maraming nabitin kay Dex. Gusto pa nila ng stock tips. So we will definitely bring them back if they still want. Hi, Tats. You're on the stream again. Thank you so much. Tats is the creator of On the Money and the one who started my TV career kahit na pang-print lang naman talaga me. Pero maraming salamat, Dex. Thank you for the gift
thank
of
you,
your
time.
Get going, Jerry. Kumu, thank you so much.
Thanks, guys.
RJ, always such a fan. Thank you for being the batang 80s for me.
God bless.
And always, partner Warren. My partner in crime. Please follow Warren De Guzman, WD De Guzman on Twitter. Always watch us.
Ikaw naman. Buhay pa kami in the service of the Filipino.
Okay. And then Fridays on Kumu, Fridays on Kumu 5:30, Saturdays on Kumu Sin Zone 3 to 4 p.m. and YouTube Live every 8 to 9 p.m. Saturdays. Thank you so much. Subscribe. Share the links. Thank you so much.
Thanks, guys.
Bye, you guys. Enjoy Saturdays. Take care.
Wait, listening.